Hello students, good morning to all. So today we will start new lesson, lesson 2, input and output devices. Okay, so first of all we study about the input devices. So input means refers to the data or instructions which we feed into a computer. So whatever the instructions we give to the computer with the help of some devices like keyboard, mouse, joystick, light pen, trackball, scanner, graphic tablet, microphone, magnetic ink card reader, optical character reader, OCR, barcode reader, optical mark reader. All these are the input devices. So input devices are used to enter data and information into a computer. So why the input devices we use? We use input devices to enter data and information into the computer. And this input unit converts the incoming data and instructions into a pattern of binary codes. So to convert, because computer understands only the binary codes, digital language, zeros and one. So the purpose of this device is to convert the instructions into the binary codes, which is understood by a computer. Then it further supplies the converted data to the processor for processing. So first of all, we'll discuss the first input device, keyboard. So see, so this keyboard, you can see keyboard is the most common and very popular input device which helps to input data to the computer. And the layout of the keyboard is just like a traditional typewriter, although there are some additional keys and provided for performing additional functions. That is the QWERTY keyboard, just like a typewriter. So keyboards are of two sizes, 84 keys or 101 or 202 keys. Two types of keyboards are in the market, one keyboard which contains 84 keys and second keyboard which can contain 101 or 102 keys. But now keyboards with 104 or 108 keys are also available in for Windows and the internet. So the how many categories of keyboards are now you are knowing? 84 keys keyboard are also there, 101, 102, 104 or 108. So latest maximum size of the keys on the keyboard is 108 keys keyboard also you can get. So these are that keyboards only. Some keyboards contain 84 keys, some 101, some 102. But nowadays keyboards with 104 or 108. So the exact answer for today's scenario is 104 or 108. The keys on the keyboards are as follows. Which types of keys are on the keyboards? You find. First, the typing keys. These keys include the letter A to Z, digit keys 0 to 9, digit keys 0 to 9, which generally give the same layout as that of the typewriter. So that is called the numeric keypad. Second, function keys. It is used to enter the numeric data or cursor movement. Generally, it consists of a set of 17 keys. Function keys contain 17 keys that are laid out in the same configuration used by most adding machines and calculators. That is the numeric keypad. Typing keys. This numeric keypad contains the set of 17 keys. Now, function keys. Third one. 12 function keys are present on the keyboard. How many function keys are present on the keyboard? 12 function keys are present on the keyboard. And numeric keys are 17. 12 function keys are present on the keyboard, which are arranged in a row at the top of the keyboard. Each function key has a unique meaning and is used for some specific purpose. So function keys are used for specific purpose. Control keys. These keys provide cursor and screen control. It includes four directional arrow keys also. Control keys also include the home key, end key, insert, delete, page up, page down, control, alternate, escape. All these are the control keys. Special purpose keys. Keyboards also contain some special purpose keys such as enter, shift, caps lock, num lock, space bar, tab and print screen. These are the special purpose keys. Okay, some are also called the navigation keys. So function keys are also called the F1, F2, also called the navigation keys. Function keys is also called navigation keys. Now next you can see the mouse. In the book it is given wrong, you can find 36. The navigation keys definition is written as down in the function keys and function keys definition is written in the navigation key. So they are taken in the navigation keys written there are used to perform the specific task. This is the definition of the function key. Okay, so you exchange it. In the book it is given wrong. Next. Mouse. Next input device is the mouse. Mouse is the most popular pointing device. It is called a pointing device. Very famous cursor control device having a small palm-sized box with a round ball at its base. In the mechanical mouse, a round ball is there which senses the movement of the mouse and sends corresponding signals to the CPU. So, a single left click selects an item. The left mouse button is used more frequently used on the mouse. Which left mouse button? Generally, it has two buttons. Left and right button, and a wheel is present between the button. A mouse can be used to control the position of the cursor on the screen, but it cannot be used to enter the text into the computers. With help of the mouse, we cannot enter the text, but we select the items, we select the icons on the screen, desktop. Right click often displays a list of commands on the screen. A single left click selects an item, while double clicking on an item activates the application, means opens the application. So, in comparison to the right button, left mouse button is used more frequently. Dragging and dropping makes it easy to move an item on the screen. If you want to move any item on the screen, so what we do? Drag and drop. For that purpose, we are using some things. This is the mouse. This mouse is of three types: mechanical mouse, optomechanical mouse, and optical mouse. Mouse is of three types. Mechanical mouse, which we have discussed, which contains a metal ball or rubber ball on its lower side. It can roll in all the directions. The screen pointer moves according to the movement of the ball. But in the optomechanical mouse, this type of mouse used as a mechanism similar to the mechanical mouse. The only difference is that it uses the optical sensor to detect the movement of the ball. Yet this optical mechanical mouse also contains the ball, but for the movement of the cursor pointer, it uses the optical sensor. Third is the optical mouse, which does not use the ball. Optical mouse does not have any mechanical moving parts. The laser technology is used to detect the movement of the mouse. It is more efficient and expensive than the mechanical and optomechanical mouse. Okay. Now, what are the advantages of this mouse? Easy to use, not very expensive. Moves the cursor faster than the arrow keys of the keyboard. Now, next is the stylus. So here this is the joystick. So joystick is a pointing device which is used to move the cursor position on a monitor screen. It is a stick having a spherical ball at its both lower and upper ends. And the lower spherical ball moves in a socket. You can see lower spherical ball moves in a socket. And the joystick can be moved in all four directions. So this joystick is also an input device. So the function of the joystick is similar to that of the mouse. It is commonly used in the CAD and playing computer game. Joystick is used for the designing, the architecture of the building, hospitals and other things. Okay, next is the light pen. Light pen is a pointing device similar to a pen. It is used to select a displayed menu item or draw pictures on the monitor screen. It consists of a photocell and an optical system placed in a small tube. So when the tip of the light pen is moved over the monitor screen and then pen button is pressed, its photocell sensing element detects the screen location and sends the corresponding signal to the CPU. That is the light pen. So this is also easy to use and helpful for the programs like SCAD for drawing. We are using this. Next is the trackball. Trackball is also an input device that mostly used in the notebook or laptop computer. And instead of mouse, this is a ball which is half inserted, and by moving fingers on the ball, the pointer can be moved. That is a trackball. Since the whole device is not moved, so trackball requires less space than a mouse. So here we rotate only this ball, not we move the entire mouse, so it requires a less space. So a trackball comes in various shapes like a ball, button or a square. Okay, next is the stylus. Stylus is also a small instrument shaped like a pen and that is used to provide input to the mobile devices. So stylus is used on the mobile devices or on the projectors, computer screens and tablets. It can be used to draw or make selections on touchscreen devices directly on the screen. So this stylus is used on the touchscreen devices. Using stylus instead of a mouse or a trackball is called a pen computing. So stylus of using stylus called pen computing. Stylus is used on the game consoles like Nintendo. Next is the scanner. The scanner is also an input device which works like a photocopy machine. It is used when some of the information is available on paper and is to be transferred onto the hard disk. If you want to save that information on the hard disk of the computer for further manipulation, for making any changes, you can do that. Like this is the scanner. Scanner captures the images. This is the image diagram of the scanner. Scanner captures the images from the source, which are then converted into a digital form that can be stored on the disk. These images can be edited before they are printed. So there are many types of the scanners: drum scanner, flatbed scanner, handheld scanner. Three types of scanners are there. That also we will study in detail. Now first drum scanner. So drum scanner is most efficient and expensive scanner. It uses a rotating glass. Drum scanner uses a rotating glass drum to scan. In a drum scanner, the light from the object that is to be scanned is split into separate red, blue and green beams optically, making the image precise. So this mechanism is called the photomultiplier tubes, PMT technology. So drum scanner uses the PMT technology, which is called the photomultiplier tubes. So in this drum scanner, there is a rotating glass which rotate the drum and scan the light from the object that is to be scanned. So from that object of which you placed on this glass, it is captures that light and split it into the separate red, blue and green beams optically, making the image precise. Drum scanners are used mainly in the publishing industry to print high quality images in the books and magazines. Next is the flatbed scanner. This is the flatbed scanner you can see, you are seeing. This is popular desktop scanner. It looks like a miniature printer with a flip up cover. This is a flip up cover protecting the glass window. It is in a flatbed scanner. The object to be scanned is placed face down to the glass window, which is then illuminated with a bright light. It uses the CCD, charged couple device technology. Flatbed scanner is using CCD technology to read the entire area optically. Depending on its size, flatbed scanner can fit a standard or legal size document. And this flexible cover allows you to scan books, newspaper, articles, photographs, etc. Last scanner is the handheld scanner. With the help of the hand also you can do the scanning. This is a small manual device dragged over the surface of the image to be scanned. So what the image you want to scan, you have to drag the handheld scanner over that image. These scanners are operated by hand. Difficult to operate these scanners as they need a steady hand to scan objects in order to avoid distorted images. So if you move so fast, if there is not a continuous movement, uniform movement you are not doing, so there will be some distortion in the images. Barcode scanner is the most utilized handheld scanner in the shopping mall. That is the handheld scanner. So this is all for the today, students. In the next class, we'll continue our discussion about the remaining topics of the input devices. Thank you for your kind attention.